to this and other weird IB video projects. We are sorry.
It's a beautiful day in this neighborhood, a beautiful day for a neighbor. Would you be mine? Could you be mine? It's a neighborly day in this beauty wood, a neighborly day for a beauty. Would you be mine? Could you be mine? I have always wanted to have a neighbor just like you. I've always wanted to live in a neighborhood with you, so let's make the most of this beautiful day. Since we're together, we might as well say, would you be mine? Could you be mine? Won't you be my neighbor? Won't you please? Won't you please? Please, won't you be my neighbor?
Hi, neighbor. These are today's items of the day. This is a coloring book. Do you like to color? I like to color. I just got this one, so I only started the front page. And this is a belt. It's nice and sturdy. We're not going to use it for the traditional reasons, though.
Oh, why, it's the postman.
Hi, Mutton Chops. Chops. We have a package for you.
Oh, a package. Hello.
Yeah, it's this guy.
Oh, you finally came. How did you get him? Good to know. Well, how's it going?
It's going good.
Are you sure it's the right one?
Yes, I'm positive.
Okay, well, let's bring him in.
Get in there.
Come on, come on.
Get in there.
Come on.
Sit down.
Pupsy? Yeah, sit down.
Pupsy.
Now.
Now then, is there anything you'd like to tell us today?
All you commie bastards, I hate the lot of you. You all can burn in hell, you goddamn. Oh, this is why the rich upper class is always taking it
calm
out.
Calm down, man.
Remember, kids, violence is never the answer.
God damn, I'd rip your throat out if
really? That, get up. Let's see it. Let's see it.
Always use your words to solve a crisis.
Now, we're going to try a simple exercise to cure your behavior. Can you tell me what you see in this image? Oh, hold on.
It's doing the rock jump.
What about this one?
It's doing the rock Johnson, pouring some beautiful maple syrup on some pancakes.
What about this?
That's Dwayne the Rock Johnson holding a little kitty cat.
Okay. What about this one?
Dwayne the Rock Johnson on an ATV four-wheeler. Those four-wheelers are for the white folk!
Alright, so that didn't work out as expected, but I have another idea. How would you like a puppet show with the King Friday? Now, this is you, okay? And this is Kitty Cat, who's gonna teach you a lesson, okay?
I think I give a shit about any goddamn puppet show. I don't care.
Now then, postman, would you kindly bring the package inside?
Get in there.
Well, you ready?
Thank you. goddamn comedies. Now, where in the blue-eyed, white-skinned Christian God's name am I?
You're in the puppetizer time machine. Didn't you read the sign?
What? What happened to my white skin? My superiority is gone.
Oh, so you're still like that, huh? I guess we gotta fix you up. We're gonna show you some history to fix that mind of yours.
The only thing you need to fix up is my goddamn neighbors. I live next to too many. Now, who the fuck is that behind me? What kind of libtard magic are you son of bitches pulling, huh?
No more questions. It's time for a show. I don't know what show. You're here to be fixed. My apologies, but for the meantime, we have to quiet you. You see, film and other medias help us understand things better. Let's listen to one of our neighbors and hear what he has to say. Maybe this will help.
A 250,000 people gathered at the Lincoln Memorial in the nation's capital, hoping to draw attention to injustices faced by Black Americans. That march on Washington included Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.
I have a dream
and his vision for an America without racism.
The I Have a Dream speech was a vision of what we wanted America to be. It's a vision of what America can be, but is not yet.
Nearly six decades later, Dr. Salika Duxworth-Lawton, a history professor at UW-Eau Claire, says that dream is yet to become a reality.
Because we're not equal until we are all treated equal. And the people who want to say there is no racism today are deluding themselves. Martin Luther King wanted a very disciplined civil rights movement. He didn't want riots, but he understood riots as the voice of people unheard.
Happy to join with you today in what will go down in history as the greatest demonstration for freedom in the history of our nation. Five score years ago, a great American in whose symbolic shadow we stand today signed the Emancipation Proclamation. This momentous decree came as a great beacon light of hope to millions of Negro slaves who had been seared in the flames of withering injustice. It came as a joyous daybreak to end the long night of their captivity. But 100 years later, the Negro still is not free. 100 years later, the life of the Negro is still sadly crippled by the manacles of segregation and the chains of discrimination. 100 years later, the Negro lives on a lonely island of poverty.
I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal. I have a dream that one day on the red hills of Georgia, the sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners, will they be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood? I have a dream that one day, even the state of Mississippi, a state sweltering with the heat of injustice, sweltering with the heat of oppression, will be transformed into an oasis of freedom and justice. I have a dream. My four little children
will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today. I have a dream that one day, down in Alabama, with its vicious racists, with its governor having his lips dripping with the words of interposition and nullification. One day right there in Alabama, little black boys and black girls will be able to join hands with little white boys and white girls as sisters and brothers. I have a dream today. I have a dream that one day every valley shall be exalted. Every hill and mountain shall be made low, the rough places will be made plain, and the crooked places will be made straight, and the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together. This is our hope. This is the faith that I go back to the South with. With this faith, we will be able to hew out of the mountain of despair a stone of hope. With this faith, we will be able to transform the jangling discords of our nation into a beautiful symphony of brotherhood. With this faith, we will be able to work together, to pray together, to struggle together, to go to jail together, to stand up for freedom together, knowing that we will be free one day. This will be the day with all of God's children. Be able to sing with new meaning, my country, tears of thee. Sweet land of liberty, of thee I sing. Land where my fathers died, land of the pilgrim's pride. From every mountainside, let freedom ring. And if America is to be a great nation, this must become true. And so let freedom ring from the prodigious hilltops of New Hampshire.
That was beautiful. The speech, the war forms, the etiquette response, it was absolutely indubitably beautiful. I don't know, it was just perfection to its greatest. It's just what I dream to be.
So, what have you learned today?
Well, I've learned that there are a lot of nuances to race, and I can't just make assumptions and generalizations about one race from one experience that I have, or something that I've seen on the media. There's a lot more diversity to these races, and I should understand that, and continue my efforts in understanding these people.
So you're no longer racist?
I would say so, no. I do not feel racist. I do not carry hate in my heart. Unless we're talking about commies, in which case they could burn in hell. But for races, yeah.
Baby steps.
Sure.
Okay. Well, you can go now.
All right.
I've had a great time, neighbor.
Yes. And I, too, have had a great time.